Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on the subject steam boiler. And this is lecture number 4 on steam boiler. The topic for discussion is boiler draught and the types of the boiler draught. So boiler draught is defined as the small pressure difference that causes the flow of the fresh air to the combustion chamber of the boiler or furnace. So we require air for combustion, the air supplied to the boiler by means of draught. The draught is created, which is the pressure difference between the atmospheric air and the pressure of the gases in the inside the combustion chamber. The draught is required to maintain continuous flow of sufficient supply of air to complete combustion of the fuel. The draught is required to draw the hot gases through fuel bed, furnace, superheater, economizer, air preheater and across other parts of the boiler plant. And the draught is required to exhaust the flue gases to the atmosphere after utilizing the heat energy. So the draught is the pressure difference created, the pressure difference between the atmospheric air and the hot gases, which is required for these three functions: to maintain continuous flow of the air to the complete combustion of the fuel, to flow the hot gases through various components of the boiler, and to exhaust the flue gases to the atmosphere. So there are two types of draught. So natural draught and artificial draught. Natural draught is created by temperature difference of the hot gases and the atmospheric air, and the artificial draught, it is created by a mechanical system. So artificial it is created, and the artificial draught is further classified into mechanical draught and the steam jet draught, and this mechanical draught further classified into three types: induced draught, forced draught and the balanced draught. And the steam jet draught is also classified into induced draught and the forced draught. So we will study about the construction arrangement for various types of draught and their relative advantages of the draughts. First, the natural draught. So natural draught is produced by the chimney. It is also called as chimney draught. Now look at the arrangement of the various boiler parts and the chimney. So we have the grate level, that is the furnace level, or the grate is the place where the burning of the fuel is taking place, and the air is flowing through the boiler, economizer and main flue passage and then to the chimney. And there is pressure difference between the atmosphere, actually the pressure difference of the hot gases here, atmospheric air, and the atmospheric air on the entry, and the column of the hot gases inside the chimney. So the flow of the gas is created by the temperature difference because of the density difference, which is caused by the temperature difference. The chimney is a vertical tubular structure made of brick masonry, reinforced concrete or steel. So the relatively brick masonry is easy to build and it is very strong. It can be used for a longer time. And reinforced concrete or the steel structure, normally we don't prefer because for a smaller capacity boiler we can use the steel structure. For higher capacity, either brick masonry or reinforced concrete, they are used for the chimney. Chimney carries the flue gases to a height before discharging to the atmosphere, such that it does not cause harm to the surrounding. So chimney, if you look at the boiler plant, the chimney is very tall, more than 90 meter height for a 210 megawatt boiler. So if you go to the Neyveli, so you can see the tall chimney in the Neyveli thermal power station. So the chimney height is 92 meters from the ground. And the natural draught is produced by the temperature difference between the hot gases inside the chimney and the atmospheric air outside the chimney. So the temperature difference, it causes the density difference. Temperature difference, it creates the density difference, and the density difference is the driving force for driving for flow of the hot gases and the atmospheric air. And the pressure difference caused by the chimney draught or the natural draught, delta P equal to rho A minus rho G into G into H, where rho A is the density of the atmospheric air, rho G is the density of the hot gases, and G is the acceleration due to gravity, H is the height of the chimney. So the pressure, if you want to produce higher pressure difference for the draught system, we require to increase the height of the chimney. So that is main criteria. So when you want to produce more pressure difference for the flow of air and the hot gases in the natural system, we have to increase the height of the chimney. So that is only disadvantage. Otherwise, it is very easy to maintain and a simple method of natural draught. The advantages of natural draught, it does not require any external power for producing the draught. So it is naturally produced by means of temperature difference. The capital investment is less. The maintenance cost is nil as there is no mechanical part. The chimney keeps the flue gases at a high place in the atmosphere, which prevents the contamination of the atmosphere. And it has a long life. These are all the advantages. And disadvantages of the natural draught, the draught produced is less and depends on the atmospheric condition and the height of the chimney. The efficiency of the boiler plant is less. Because the draught is less, the amount of airflow is minimum. So the efficiency of the boiler plant is less in the case of natural draught system. But in the modern boiler nowadays, we are using only the artificial draught system. So the in the artificial draught system, first we take the induced mechanical draught. So here, so we have the various components and you can look at the arrangement of the boiler. Arrangement of boiler, economizer, air preheater, ID fan, and we have a chimney, and through the chimney the hot gases are flowing to the atmosphere. Now here the draught is produced by the induced draught fan. ID fan is the induced draught fan. The mechanical draught is also called as fan draught, induced fan draught. And the fan is drawing the air. So from the atmosphere, it is drawing the air. The fan is the device which is circulating the air, which is taking the air from the atmosphere and supplying the hot gases to the atmosphere through the chimney. So the fan is inducing the flow of air from the atmosphere through the grate, economizer, air preheater, and this ID fan is handling hot gases. So for handling hot gases, the specific volume is high, density is low. So the fan size will be relatively bigger in the case of ID fan. And the chimney, the relative height of the chimney comparing with natural draught is very minimum in the case of mechanical draught system. And a forced mechanical draught, this is the layout of the forced mechanical draught. You look at it here, we have the boiler and the furnace or the grate. So the blower is outside the boiler. Now the blower is supplying, forcing the air through various components. So in the case of forced draught system, the blower is handling only the atmospheric air. So the relative size of the blower is smaller comparing with the induced draught fan. Now the air will be flowing through the various devices like a grate, furnace, then the economizer, air preheater, and then it goes to the atmosphere through the chimney. And here the main drawback in the case of forced draught system, mechanical system, the pressure difference in the grate, economizer will be better, and in the later stage the pressure difference will be less. In the case of induced draught fan, induced draught system, so the pressure difference at the boiler grate will be little bit lower comparing with the chimney and the air preheater. So near the fan there will be more pressure difference, away from the fan the pressure difference will be less. To manage these two, we are installing the balanced mechanical draught system, where we are installing both the FD fan and ID fan. So FD fan is forced draught fan and ID fan is the induced draught fan. So the FD fan is forcing the air through the grate and the economizer, air preheater. ID fan is drawing, inducing the flow, and then it is supplying the hot gases to the atmosphere via the chimney. So the balanced draught, here we use two fan, one is FD fan, another one is ID fan. Now we compare between the induced and the forced draught system. So induced draught system and the forced draught. In the induced draught system, it handles hot gases of higher specific volume. So the induced draught, whereas the forced draught system, it handles cold air of lower specific volume. So induced draught system, it requires the fan size is larger, whereas in the forced draught system, the fan size is smaller. And in the induced draught system, it needs water cooled bearing to withstand the high temperature, because the entire fan is available, entire fan unit is available, it is handling only hot gases, the bearing, fan bearing should be water cooled. Whereas in the forced draught system, the water cooled bearing are not required. So we can use ordinary bearings for the forced draught system. So induced draught system, there is a rush of cold air into the furnace. When the door is opened, so the atmospheric air will rush into the combustion chamber. So there is no possibility of the burnt gases from the furnace, the leakage of hot gases to the backflow of the hot gases from the furnace to the atmosphere is not possible. In the case of induced draught system, when you open the door, automatically the atmospheric air will rush into the combustion chamber. Whereas in the case of forced draught system, so inside the furnace or the grate, the pressure will be higher. So when you open the door, combustion chamber door, when the boiler is in operating condition, so there is a possibility of the fire leaking. Fire is coming out of the boiler. It leads to some kind of accident. So the uniform flow of air in the furnace and the grate is possible. At the same time, this is also possible gas leakage. So no possibility of gas leakage to the atmosphere, as the pressure inside is always lower than the atmospheric pressure. So here, in the case of forced draught system, possibility of gases leak to the atmosphere when the combustion chamber door is opened. So these are all the difference between induced draught system and the forced draught system. And the relative advantage of forced draught over induced draught. Forced draught fan does not require water cooled bearing. Tendency of air leak into the boiler furnace is reduced. So no loss of ingress of cold air through the furnace door when they are opened for air and cleaning. The fan size and the power required for the same draught is less in the case of forced draught fan compared with the induced draught, as it handles cold air. So this is the advantage of forced draught system over the induced draught system. And advantages of mechanical or a fan draught system over natural draught system. So mechanical draught system or the fan draught system, they are easy to control, easy control of combustion and evaporation. Increase the evaporative power of the boiler, that is the amount of steam produced is increased by using the mechanical draught system. The improvement in the thermal efficiency of the plant, reduces the chimney height of the plant. It prevention of smoke, the black smoke in the boiler. Capability of consuming low grade coal. So when you have mechanical draught system, we can use the low grade coal for combustion. The amount of fuel consumption is 15% less than the natural draught system. Rate of fuel burning increases and the amount of heat generated is also increasing. The efficiency of the mechanical draught is 7%, whereas the efficiency of natural draught is 1%. So normally in the modern high pressure boiler, we are using mechanical draught system. In particular, we are using the balanced draught system in the case of boiler plant. And the steam jet draught. So the steam jet draught, it has more advantage than any other type of the draught system, because it does not require any fan or a tall chimney. Now we have to take a small quantity of the steam which is leaving the steam engine or the steam turbine. So the steam from the steam engine and the filled steam turbine is admitted here in the chamber, in the boiler drum. So when the steam is entering, so the steam is already density, very low density of the steam. So it absorbs the heat energy and further heated, and it creates vacuum here. So because of this evaporation of the steam, it creates vacuum here, and this vacuum created, it draws the hot gases through the various boiler parts, and this waste steam along with the flue gases, they are leaving to the atmosphere. So steam jet draught, it is very easy and it is very clean and it is efficient comparing with the mechanical draught system. So the advantages of steam jet draught: simplicity in operation, cheaper in cost, maintenance free, and there is no maintenance cost. It requires little space for installation, capability of using low grade coal. These are all the advantages of steam jet draught. So we stop here. So these are all the books I published in the mechanical engineering subject: design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where the video lectures of all the subjects are uploaded for the benefit of the student. Also, the gate solutions video on the gate solutions are also uploaded in the YouTube channel. So you can subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning and the pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. So you please post your comments on the YouTube comments box for improving the videos. You can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification. I will sincerely answer. So we'll meet again in another video on the steam boiler.